Hello, High Levelers. Ray O'Daniel here. Got another interesting video. In this video, what we're going to talk about is something that probably is overlooked by a lot of people and just taken for granted. It's the media library inside of GoHighlevel. Before we get started, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please click the subscribe link below. I always appreciate your support. Alrighty, let's get to it. So, the media library is the main data storage facility that houses all of the files and uploads that you put in a funnel or anywhere within GoHighlevel. Now, we're inside of a demo account here inside of Highlevel, and what I want to show you first of all is where the media library is. So if you go into your settings and you click on media, right here is your media library. We're going to go ahead and click open media library, and we're just going to walk through a few things here. If you've never logged in or looked at this, this is a very similar, if you've ever dealt with WordPress Media Library, very similar experience. But there are a few hidden resources that maybe people are not familiar with. So here are several files that we've uploaded. As you can see, this is a GIF, this is a PNG file. So all of these are image files. If we look over here, this is an MP4, which is a video file. This is another video file. You can tell by the icons here. And then we've got several other images that we've uploaded for just various testing purposes that we have. Now, one of the things I also want to make sure that you're aware of is that there is a folder structure. Here you can create folders, and this is what the folders look like. You can just simply come up here to the top right, create a folder or upload a file. So right now, creating folders is just a great way to organize all of your data inside of Highlevel to make sure that you keep everything separate and just store things so that they're not always at the root and you have to scroll and scroll to find stuff. It's nice to just put, if you have certain logos or professional business logos, maybe you'll create a folder for your business logos and put them all in there. That way, whenever you go look for them, you know exactly where they are. So one of the things I do want to show you here is at the very top, create image using AI. Now, I'm not going to go over that in this video. I've created a whole other video regarding image creation AI on my channel that you can go take a look at, but this is a great feature they built directly into the media library where you can create your own images with Highlevel. Now, when you do that, I will let you know that this new content AI folder is here by default. Highlevel creates that itself. If you ever see that, this means that all of the images that you create with the AI content tool are stored in this folder. So if you ever open it up, these are some of the images. I was playing with it at another presentation. But this is where all the images that get created happen. Now, of course, at the very top, if you take a look here, this is your breadcrumb. So if you're inside of a folder, you can just simply click back on the home to get back to the home screen. So just a few navigational purposes. Now, one of the things about the media library is that there is no limit currently with the storage of any files inside of Highlevel's accounts. So you can literally upload terabytes of data. Please don't. You know, Sean is probably going to kill me if that happens. But there's no limit to the data that you can put up in here as of currently right now. So any files, any images, anything that you can think of that's going to be a resource to your business, you can upload and store it inside of the Highlevel system rather than maybe keeping it on a Google Drive for a later purpose or any other kind of online cloud storage. So when you do that, sometimes you'll have to be able to clean things up. For instance, you could have outdated information inside of the media library that you want to delete. And I'm going to show you how to do that here. You also may have other media that's inside of the media library that you may want to store here, but you may want to reference in another site. So for instance, if you wanted to store an image inside of Highlevel, but reference it on an external website, how would you do that? I'll show you how to do that. So right now, if we take a look at this image right here, notice that this is one that I uploaded. And if you take a look, this icon represents a broken image. Means it's an incomplete file or something is wrong with it. Because if it was a regular image file, you see all the other image files, you get a preview of it here in the main screen. So if you do this, if you click on this, first of all, I'm going to choose another image. If you click on an image, I'm just going to blow this up. Up here in the top right corner, you get a couple of icons. This is a link to this particular file that you can have. This link is what you would use on an external website. So for instance, this image, I'm going to click on this link, copy to clipboard, and I'm going to just use a separate tab to paste it. Notice that this is a link directly to this image. Perfect. So now instead of storing an image on a Google Drive and having to share a folder and then get a shared link image or whatever, you know, Dropbox, and you're trying to get, you got all these shared image files, you can now put all of that information inside of Highlevel and then reference it using this particular link. Works perfectly fine. So you don't have to deal with all those shared permissions, view versus editor, and all that other kind of stuff. This is only simply a view-only link. So it works great if you want to reference this image on a third-party website. You can simply give this link and they'll reference it directly with inside of your media library. So this right here is the link, but you can also click on this to delete. So there's a couple of icons that some people may not be aware of. So that's one place where you can find it. Another place, if you click on the image and you right-click, you also can get the link. That's another way of getting a quick link to it. You can also move this image to a folder real quick for organization, rename it real quickly, or even delete it all within this menu. I'm gonna go ahead and click delete. It's just gonna ask you, are you sure you wanna delete this? Click delete, and now the file is gone. So these are just some of the basic functions that you can do inside of the media library, just to keep your library updated, because sometimes you do have images and videos and things like that that you may wanna clean up and get rid of inside of your media library, just to, for tidy purposes, you know, just to be organized. Now, these are some of the basic things that you can do. You can also reference videos. If you look here, this video, you can actually get a link to this particular video. So if you ever want to reference a video, you can actually stream a video from this as well. So that is a good feature that you can have as well. Now, some of the other things that I wanted to explain to you, some of the hidden resources that some people may not be aware of, is Highlevel is actually tied in to a couple of other free image online directories. So if you come up here to the very top, notice that you have a drop-down list that says My Media. This isn't the only thing in here. You can go to Backgrounds, and what this is typically would give you any backgrounds that you have. Now, if you wanted to, you could search for some. Let's just do, maybe you want to do a skyline. There we go. It just took a minute to pull up some of the background images. But here's some of the background images that, again, you can use inside of Highlevel. If you wanted to put a background image on a funnel page or a website page, any of these backgrounds are available for you that you can choose from. Now, some of the great things are these other two options, Unsplash and Pixabay. Now, before I explain that to you, I've got these pulled up here. This right here is Pixabay, noting that these are royalty-free images that you can use throughout Highlevel. So maybe you weren't aware of that, that if you have certain images that you want to pull into a funnel or a website, excuse me, and you're having problems finding an image and you're trying to go out to third-party sites and really find a good image for yourself to use, most people don't know that you can actually search for images on these free sites, royalty-free, that you can use on anywhere. You don't have to pay for them, all within the Highlevel Media Library. So that's a great resource. So this is Pixabay. You can search here. Notice that these are some of the images that you could pull up. There's also another one called Unsplash.com. Unsplash is another one that has audio images that you can pull in as well. Now, here in the media library, I'm going to go ahead and pull up Unsplash. Now, notice there's nothing in here. That's because we have to search for something. So right now, if we were to just search for something, just say a castle. Okay, so great. Look at all these pictures. These are royalty-free images that you can use, and you can type in anything that you want for this. If you want to search for castle, notice that you've got all these different type of castles. You can click on it, and you can simply utilize that inside of your website or funnel, and we'll take a look and show you how to utilize that in just a few minutes. I just wanted to show you what the media library is and what it can access. So if you wanted to, you can also do, maybe type in an operating room. Maybe you're medical and you want to, get a picture of somebody doing surgery or something like that on somebody. You see the flexibility of these royalty-free images, and all of these are integrated directly into the media library. So this is one of the other things that you can do. And again, we're using Pixabay. You can use the same keyword, switch to this option, and get maybe different images from here. Maybe you don't want a real live one. Maybe you want a cartoon one, that's going to fit in better with your scheme of what you're looking for. So all of these are great ways to add additional value when you're either building a funnel, building a website, you need to pull an image from something like that. This is a great way to do that. Now, let me show you how you can utilize that in real life. So these are some of the hidden resources that I wanted to, hopefully this video can explain to you, so you can begin using this Because right now, I know in the beginning, when I started using GoHighlevel, I did actually go, I wasn't aware of this, I didn't pay attention, and nobody really kind of told me, like in this video, that these options were available. I would go on third-party sites, or in some cases, I would actually go to buy images, because I needed an image to use on a particular website or funnel, and I had to go out and get an image to complete the project. I wasn't aware of this to be able to search for these, and I could really kind of kick myself. So I hope you appreciate the video. So here we're gonna go back to sites. I'm gonna pull up just this newsletter funnel. I use this in one of my other examples, but it's just a great example that I wanna show you. It's a very basic sort of newsletter funnel where somebody could sign up and buy a newsletter, but we're not going to be dealing with that. I just want to show you the image properties. Now, if my screen looks a little bit different, it's because I'm using the new version of the funnel editor. If you haven't done that yet, you can go underneath your settings, go to your labs, and turn on the new funnel settings. The reason I did this is because eventually this is what Highlevel is going to force on everybody. Eventually, you're going to eventually have to use this new version, and they're going to not make it available and just push it out to everybody. So might as well get used to it. But notice on this one, the image, this properties comes up on the right, where before it was on the left. You got all these other new icons, and it kind of looks a little bit different. So I just want to make sure that you understand this is Highlevel. So with this image, what we're going to do is come down here to scroll to this option right here. Notice in the image options, this is where we can click to go to the new media library. Now, I wanted to show you this because this is a cool new feature. If you click on this, notice that you have this new create image using AI built directly into the funnel editor. So this is the great thing about it. You can pull this thing up directly inside of the website or funnel editor without having to go through the media library or go someplace else to create the image and then come back into where you're at. You can all work within the same screen, create the image. So that's a great new feature that Highlevel has added as well. Right now, we're going to be using upload from media library. So I'm going to choose that. Now, when we do that, we're going to pull right back up to the media library where we can use any one of these images that we want. However, I want to sit back and use some of these new features for searching here. So let me see. I don't quite know what I'm going to get here, but let's just say I wanted to type in newsletter because this is a newsletter funnel. So you get all these nice little icons, news, newsletter. You see all the different things that you can get. Now, I didn't have to go search for this. This is just right here. All of these images are available for me to use, all royalty free. So right now, I think I'm going to just choose this one here. So if I wanted to, I can just simply double click on that and boom, there it is. I can now utilize it. Now, one of the things about this is it's great because if you take a look at the image here, what I wanted to show you is this actually references Pixel Bay directly. So what this means is, excuse me. So this right here does not put the image in your media library. It simply references this image on Pixel Bay's website. So if you take a look here and you save this, this is referencing a remote site. So again, these images, even though you can utilize them, are not stored inside of your media library. So it's not going to take up any additional space. Now, obviously, this image is pretty large for this one here. So if you did this, you probably want to put some kind of a cap on the, put some sort of a height size on it, just to make it fit your screen better. So here we're just going to make 300 pixels. So here's just how you can simply use and save your newsletter. And now you can simply preview it. And previewing it, now you get a funnel where you get a nice little newsletter. And this is available for you, again, for the Pixel Bay, as well as the Unsplash. So you don't have to go to these sites to look for this. You can access them all within the media library. So that's really what I wanted to show you, just that this additional resources are available. Maybe you've never played with the drop-down list. Maybe you've never explored the media library or know that you could reference, get a link to images that are inside of your media library and use them on third-party sites or how you do that. I hope you found the video useful. If you did, please click on the like button, leave me a comment. If you have any questions, please leave me a comment as well. I like to answer all of my comments on the videos that I have. Again, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please click the subscribe button. If you are interested in signing up for Highlevel, I would just please ask that you use my affiliate link below. I do get credit for it, and I do appreciate your support.
Thank you so much and have a great day.
Hey, if you're interested in learning more about Highlevel, click on the link below regarding my free Highlevel course. It goes over everything that you need to do to get your account created, get it set up, and get it going in about 2 days. I also, if you sign up with Highlevel with me, I do offer a snapshot as well as a client onboarding course that can be used by your client or even used to train your own team to do client onboarding. I want to thank you so much again and have a great day.